Good morning, my dear. I hope you all are fine. Students, today I am going to start a new chapter. It is MS Excel. Today I will cover 5 topics. First one, feature of spreadsheet software. Second, workbook and worksheet. Third, starting MS Excel. Fourth, components of MS Excel window. And the last one, how to create, open, save, and close a workbook. So first of all, you have to know the features. What are the features of spreadsheet software? Students, you know, MS Excel is the part of MS Office. When I'm telling MS Office, it includes many software. Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access, many are there. Okay. Today, one part that is MS Excel that I will be discussing. First of all, why we will use MS Excel? What are the benefits of MS Excel? Students, you know, in spreadsheet software, we work with data, numbers. Maybe it can be for calculation work. Maybe it can be for conditional formatting work, filtering data work. It may be, yes, for creating a chart. So one by one feature I am going to discuss, my dear. First, the main feature that is in MS Excel, you have many inbuilt tools, that is formula and functions. Like, I'm just telling about the sum. This is a function. You don't take this one as lightly, my dear. This function can help you to do the sum of any range of cells. Not only it will be for an individual row, it can be for all the rows also, or can be for multiple rows also. Next, autofill features. I will show you. You will understand it also. Now, next one, autofill feature. Autofill means I want one value to be written here, and itself, computer will give me the rest one via the help of MS Excel. Like, I have written Sun, that is Sunday, and I want rest series, click and drag it. This is called fill handle process. If you want to work on numbers, and this number should be in a series, that also you can find it. But in this, at least 2 numbers must be there. Minimum must be there. Like, I want to have the series, odd number series, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, in this way. Then first number I must write. The next number 3. What is the difference, my dear? Who is the difference? And I want this difference should be between each 2 numbers. Up to where I drag it, till there it should be in the same way. Like, I'm selecting these 2 and now I'm dragging it up to 20th row. See. what happened? Just you compare two cells, any two cells, you will be getting difference what? Only two. Two is the difference. This is the autofill. Now, next one, conditional formatting. Conditional formatting, you can understand what is conditional formatting. That means as per my condition, my data to be formatted. Like, I have been given some work. And in that strictly, I have been given, yes, one more information to me that those students who have got marks less than 40 must be in red color. Here I have applied the condition. What? The marks which will be less than 40, wherever, that all numbers must be marked with which color? Red color. This is called conditional formatting. That means once I have applied this condition, it will be valid for my seat. Next one is filtering data. I want to filter my data. Like more than 30, less than 30. Whatever my condition is, and according to that, I want to filter my data. Like, I want to see only roll number 29. This is also called filtering of data. Next, chart. You know, you are having your numbers here, but numbers cannot make easier for you to find out which student is not well in my subject or in other subject. The pictorial representation of your data can help you a lot. And how you can do this? Only by the help of chart. So there are many features. I cannot count these all features. Like sorting. You can do the sorting either in ascending order or descending order. You can even apply border to your cells also. You know, when I will print this one, this sheet, I will be not getting border, simple. But I want my border to be there. Like I'm showing you, I'm going on file. And then print option. Now you see in print preview, my datas are there, but datas are not having the borders. It's the border is not there. You see, every data you can see, not a single data is having border in it, but I can apply border to my cells. You see it. Only I want up to 10th row. Okay. Now. Just you watch. This I will be discussing, my dear. But only I am saying you, just you watch it. Whether the border has come or not, I am going to show you. It has come. Now, if suppose you are having 10 datas in each row, if you will not have border, you cannot identify it. If once you have taken out the printout, you cannot identify it. Maybe your finger can go to other row, but if you have the border, you can understand it. These are the boundaries by which I can identify that values. Okay, now what is my next topic? Workbook and worksheet. Students, you are having the concept of document and pages in MS Word. If I'm talking about page, it is an individual. like page 1, page 2, page 3. These are individual pages. But when all the pages are joined, it is called as document. What is called? Called as document. Same concept we have in Excel also. Okay, I will show first Excel. Now, you can see, my dear, you are having your sheet. This is my sheet 1. You can see this is my sheet 1, which consists of rows and columns. Now, I can have another sheet also. Only I have to click on plus sign. What will happen? Sheet 2 will appear. Sheet 3 will appear. Just you think this all sheets as pages in MS Word. And number of pages that all pages when joined is to given a shape what? Of document. Same way here. If you will have the collection of sheets, that will form what? So I'm saying, what is workbook? Workbook is collection of sheets. Whereas worksheet is an individual page of your workbook. Like sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5. By default, we have 3 sheets, but you can have more than 3 sheets. It is up to you that how many sheets you have. Now, when I'm saying, my dear, sheet, then you have a limitation also. What number of rows, number of columns? You cannot increase number of rows and columns. If once your sheet 1 is over, then you have to go to sheet 2. Now, I'm going to tell you how many rows are there and how many columns are there in your Excel. Just now you can see, I'm having, you know, all know that your vertical lines which you have, that is A, B, C, these are your columns. These all are shown in a vertical fashion. But when I am having the concept of horizontal, yes, lines, then it will be the rows. Like you can see, my dear, if I'm talking about A, this is called, sorry, this is called what? Column 1, column 2, column 3. Like this, how many columns you have? You can see. The last column that you will see is XFD. This is my last column. So in exam, this type of question can come. In Excel, the last column is represented by, then you will say XFD. Understood? Now, same way you have the concept of rows also. There also you have limitation. What is the maximum rows that you can have in a sheet? That is 10,48,576. You can see at the bottom, I'm going to zoom it. Yes, you can see. It is 10,48,576. You must have to remember, but already all the cells you have utilized of sheet 1, then anyhow, you have to go to sheet 2. Clear? Now, the next topic, how to start Excel. I know everyone is knowing how to open any application. If you are going to open MS Excel, click on start. Now you can type here. Wait. So you have restriction, number of rows and number of columns. Okay. Now I was talking how to start. every word can be done by typing yes 3 or 4 letters directly on the search box. If I want Excel, then only I have to write EXCE. Now you can see already my application name, it is showing. If I want to explore this one, go there and click it. Your Excel will be explored. Okay. Now, my next topic is, what are the components of MS Excel window? Just you can see, I have opened just now my Excel. Now you can see different components. I'm not going to talk about those topics which already I discussed in MS Word, like what is quick access toolbar. I'm not going to discuss this one. What is tab? What is commands? These topics I'm not going. What is status bar? I'm not going. The new topic that I'm going to discuss, my dear. First of all, that is your name box. Just now you can see. This is called as name box, which shows that where is your cursor. Your cursor is in which cell? Just now my cursor is in D1. Now I'm going to change it. Just now you see, I have gone to R7. Just now you can see. Now, is it showing R7? It defines your cell. You are in which cell? Just next to that, you will see this is called as formula bar. You can see. Okay. Even you write the value, that value will be displayed. You see, if I am writing 1, 3, and 5. Now you see, these all values are shown there. Just let me remove this one. Now you see, when I'm pointing on A1, in the name box, it is showing A1, but in the formula bar, you see the value it is showing. Now, here I can use the sum. Now, whatever I am writing here, you see, A1 colon C1. Now, just now you can understand that what is the actual use of formula bar. Just now it is showing 8, but when I will move my mouse pointer and click on D1, is it 8 that will be shown in the formula bar? No, my dear. It will now show your formula. What the formula, what the function that you have applied in D1. Just now you see it. Just now first you see. When I'm going on 3, it is showing 3. It is showing 4. But when I will go on 8, you see what it is showing. It is not showing 8 because this is not a normal value. It has come by adding A1, B1, and C1. That's why it is showing the value 8. So that's why I said this one is called as formula bar. Now, next one, how to create, open, save, and close. I hope everyone is knowing. Then also, if it is given in your syllabus, then I have to teach you. See, if you have to do any operation like open, close, save, then you must have to go to file. Just click on file. Just you can see save is there, new is there, open is there. When you will use new, when you want to start a new work, you want to open a new file, then you must have to click on new. Just I'm clicking on new. It is showing blank workbook. I will click on that. Now you see a fresh workbook containing sheet 1 has been explored. Next. File. Open. When I will use open, when already my file is available in my hard disk or in my external storage device. Like, I'm having 6, 7. This is also Excel file. Now, it has shown. Now, when I will use save, when I want to save my current workbook. Listen, don't be confused, my dear. If I have worked on three sheets, that is sheet one, sheet two, sheet three, then individually you have to save these sheets? No, my dear. Because already when I started the class, I already said you, workbook is what? Collection of sheets. And now when I am working on a file, saving a file, it means I am saving the workbook. And if I will save my workbook, it means what? Automatically, my sheets also will be saved. So if you want your sheet to be saved, then it's better that you save your workbook. Now, when you will use save as? If you want to save your file with other name, then you must go for save as option and close. See, there are two options, my dear. One is file close and other one is file exit. You see, file close. And the next one is file exit. Both are different, my dear. See, when I will use file close, what will happen? My workbook will be closed. Please keep it in mind. Because I already said, when I'm working on file, it means I'm working on workbook, not on worksheet. So when I will go for file close, what will happen? My workbook will be closed. And when I will go for file exit, what will happen? My workbook as well as MS Excel application window will be closed. Just now you see file, wait. Now file close I am doing. It means my MS Excel should not be closed. Only my workbook will be closed. You see, file close. File as it was showing earlier. Now, I don't want to save it. Many files are there. So let me close. Yes. Now, I want to work on any file. Like, this one is the file. Now, I'm going to use file close. See. What happened? My workbook has been closed, but not my application. But if I use file exit, actually here it is not there, so I will go directly here. This is file exit. When I will click on cross, what happened? My workbook as well as application window, that is MS Excel application window, both have been closed. So this is the difference between file exit and file close. I hope you all have understood this topic, my dear. Thank you.